In this video, we will show you the method of transferring Google Apps to another account or domain, and how to migrate G Suite data successfully. We bring you an effective and efficient solution with Systools Migrator software. Now let's check out the main features of the software. The tool provides option to assign priority to users while performing G Suite migration. The software includes specialized error handlers, which auto-detects internet connection loss and resumes migration successfully. Multiple options to perform source and destination user ID mapping is provided by the software. And the tool is compatible with all Windows versions. Now let's check out the prerequisites before installing the software. Make sure that you create Google Console project. Also, make sure to add scopes and validate both source and destination admin accounts. Destination users should be already created at destination admin account. And if you are using any of the Windows versions mentioned here, then please launch the tool as run as administrator. And also make sure that you use a valid SMTP, because it is case sensitive. Now let's install and run the tool to check its working process. From the home screen, click Register button to start the process. Then in the next window, enter the customer details. In order to register as a new customer, select the New Customer Radio button option, and after entering further details, hit Continue button below to proceed. Now let's choose the existing customer option in our example. Here you have to enter the mail ID you have used for registering, and hit Continue button. Then a small window appears, and enter the activation code. You will be getting a mail with activation code and the mail ID, which you have used for product registration. And if you didn't find the activation code in your inbox, please make sure to check either spam folder or junk folder. After entering the details, hit activate button below to proceed. And after successful validation, hit OK. In the next window, you have to enter the list of domains for which its users will be migrated. And then click plus icon to add the domain lists. And then click continue button below. And in the next window, select the source and destination options from the drop down. And click next button below. In the next window, you have to enter source admin mail ID in the field option below. But before that, make sure that all the prerequisites are met. You have to add scopes and validate source and destination admin accounts to perform migration successfully. You can see a video link on the top right corner of this video, or you will find related video links in the descriptions field below. Now go to Settings menu, and in the Source Service Account Client ID field, enter the ID, which was created while creating Google Console project, and also provide the source P12 key path from the saved location. Similarly, you have to enter the Destination Service Account ID and respective P12 key path in the field option below. Make sure that you perform all the prerequisites to obtain all the relevant details. After entering the details, click Save button. After that, click Connect button. Now you can see the successfully authenticated message. And then hit Next button below. Then in the next step, you have to enter the destination admin mail ID in the field option. But make sure that all the prerequisites are met. Then hit Connect button, and the account will be validated. After successful authentication, click Next button. In the next window, you can see further filter options to choose. From the categories, you can choose mails, calendars, contacts and documents. Check or uncheck the options depending on your requirements. And the date filter options further lets you apply filters according to certain date range. For example, you can apply date filter option to mails, calendars, contacts or documents, depending on your requirements. Then comes the user group mapping option. For migrating document permissions, You need to provide the CSV file containing list of source group IDs and destination group IDs. You can click on the sample CSV to view the format of the CSV file. And after saving the file on a desired location, you can hit Browse button to add the CSV file. After selecting the desired filter options, click Next button below to proceed further. And then you can see further options to choose, to perform source and destination user mapping. The Add CSV option lets users add CSV containing all the source and desired destination addresses. This method lets you maps between source and destination users. Click the sample CSV hyperlink, and you can see the CSV file format. And the next option lets users change both email and domain name, or keep the same domain name intact. And lets you choose email name such as first name, last name, etc. User can select the format and provide desired domain name. And the change only domain name option allows to change only the domain name. The user email name will be same in both source and destination. And the same as source email ID option, let users to migrate data into same ID in the destination. After making the desired options, click OK. Now you can see the tool will start fetching the users. And then it displays all the users in admin account. Software also provides option to search for any particular user by entering the name in the search field on top and hit search icon. Now you can see the mail ID that you have searched for will appear here with single or multiple results. Then you have to enter the destination mail ID in the next field. And you will find option to select all users or selected users from the drop-down option. After making the selections, click Start button to initiate the user validation process. Now you can see the number of quota allotted, remaining quota, and already consumed quota details as well. Make sure to check if this small window is hidden in the background. Click OK, and then you can see the migration process in progress. And after the process completes successfully, Tool provides option to save the export report in CSV format. Users can make use of the retry fail button to retry in case of failed migration. Tool provides option to view the completed migration process in either list view or tile view. Now let's check out how to save the export report. From the Reports menu, click Load Users button to select source domain name. And then hit Browse button to choose a destination location to save the CSV file. Now let's check out the output files. Open the destination account. And you will find the migrated data here. We are looking forward to hearing from you. Please share your valuable comments and suggestions below. And that's it. Hope you enjoyed the video. Log on to the given product page for more details and purchasing the product. For any query, mail us to support@systoolsgroup.com. Thank you for watching.